What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to mine Kylacoin on a CPU, because as we can see here, the Flex algorithm is now live on mainnet. They did fork to a new algorithm to remove FPGAs and all other hardware. This is currently now only a CPU mineable coin. Let's check it out. All right, guys, just like any cryptocurrency, the first thing you are gonna need is a wallet, and they have the Kylacoin core wallet. The latest version is version 3.3.0, so make sure you update to the latest version because it does say mandatory. So you're gonna click on this link right here, and you're gonna see the downloads are right here. So I will have this page here linked down in the description. Now, once you get it downloaded and synced up, you're gonna see this at first. You can go to the hide button here, go into file here, and create your wallet. It will make a wallet.dat file. Make sure you do save that, as that is your backup for any type of core wallet. If you mind Raptorium, pretty much anything else, Ravencoin and stuff, and you used a core wallet before, you will know there's no seed phrase, but a wallet.dat file. Save that on a USB drive. Make sure you label it, because they all get labeled the same and you don't want to mix those up. So keep that in the back of your mind. So once you get your wallet created, you can simply come into here, go to your receiving address, and then make an address here by labeling it, say CPU mining or something like that, or just my wallet. Label it whatever you want, then create the receiving address, double click it down here, and you can see this is my wallet address right here. You can use it if you want. Highly recommended to mine to your own wallet. Next up on our list is obviously our mining software. So it does sound like TT Miner is currently the highest hashing miner out there, and it was having some bugs, but this version just released today that should fix everything. As we know, with any new algorithm, any new coin, any new anything, miner updates come very fast and things are always changing. So I have been waiting for something to finally be more stable, and it sounds like it's finally here, as the beta 2 version was a nice hash rate boost here, but you have to look for your device and then manually enter it into there. And then a lot of Windows systems was actually glitching out. I had one rig that it didn't really want to even run in the first place, but now it sounds like that's all fixed. So we're coming out with this how to mine, and the latest version, TT version 2024.2.1 beta 3, sounds like it's your answer. So TT Miner here does have a HiveOS wrapper, so I'll show you how to set that up, but we're gonna start things out in Windows here. So download the zip file. So once you do download that and extract it, you're gonna come into TT Miner here, and you're gonna get a bunch of bat files. This is the TT Miner application. You may get Windows calling this a virus, like most miners, they do that. You're gonna have to accept that and possibly re-download it again, but make sure you do allow it to go through your Windows firewall. Next up, there's no bat file here designated for Kylacoin itself. I don't plan on mining Ironfish or anything, so I'm just gonna use this one. I'm actually gonna take this and just rename it. I could just copy it and that'll be easier, but I'm just gonna go Kylacoin right here, hit the enter button, and now we're just gonna edit this bat file. So let this open up. Yep, more info, run anyway, because I know this is all good. And now we're gonna adjust some parameters. So obviously our algorithm, this is Flex. So dash A, we're not mining fish hash for Ironfish, we are mining Flex for Kylacoin. So now we're gonna need our wallet. We're gonna have to skip this. We're not putting in any type of password, so we don't need that there. So we're gonna put in my wallet right here. So I'm gonna bring that back, and I'm gonna come into my wallet right here. I'm gonna go into receive, the one we set up here, and I'm gonna copy this mining address. I can just simply click right here. It makes it a lot easier. Okay, minimize that. Paste that in, control V. Here's my wallet address right here that we're gonna mine to. Worker, we're gonna get rid of this. I am gonna call this worker Rabid WS for Rabid Workstation. And now we gotta put in our pool parameters. So I'm gonna come into Viper here. And as you can see, you can pick solo or PPLNS, which is pool mining, start mining, and then choose the closest stratum for you. This is what I'm gonna use for me. So I'm gonna copy this right here, bring back our miner program here, and I'm just gonna erase this all the way to the little at symbol here. Bam, and now we're all done. This should work. So we're gonna hit file, save. That is saved up here. I'm gonna close this out, open up this. I gotta shut down some CPU miners here first because I am recorded in mining. And now I'm gonna double click on this bat file, and it should begin mining. So here you can see no dev fee, it's doing its thing, using two threads. It's gonna detect the algorithm and all this other crazy stuff, and then it should begin the mining process. There we go. As we can see, it kicked in. Let's just make this a little bit bigger. There we go. So now you can see we found a solution. We got accepted hash rate. Everything's looking good. Now, you can't judge your hash rate based on my numbers right now because, one, I have a bunch of windows open. I'm recording. This is a 7950X as well as I got my GPU going. So there's a lot of things going on. So you will have less hash rate in Windows if you have other things going on in the background. That's why Linux is always recommended, or HiveOS or other things. But this is how you set this up in Windows. Let's move on to HiveOS and figure that out. All right, so now jumping into HiveOS, the first thing you need to do is set up your wallet. So I'm gonna go into wallets right here. We're gonna click on that. I'm gonna add my wallet, go to type coin and ticker. We're gonna go KCN. As we can see, Kylacoin is added into HiveOS. So it gives you a nice fancy pink symbol. Click on that. Now enter your wallet address into here. Obviously you just bring up your wallet address again. We're going to copy here, copy address. Then you simply paste that in like so, and then name it whatever you want, like Kylacoin Core. So that way you know it's your core wallet or you're using an exchange. It's never recommended to mine to an exchange, especially after a fork and new wallets and everything are updating, but you do whatever you got to do. But in this case, always try to use the core wallets and then hit that create button. Mine's are, oh, I just hit create wallet and I didn't need to because I already had it, but whatever, don't matter. I have two wallets now, but they're both the same address. All right, so now we're gonna come into the flight sheet. We're gonna click on our coin. We're gonna go KCN. We're gonna choose Kylacoin. Now it's gonna select your wallet. So mine was called Core Main. Then we just made this one. It is now here as Kylacoin Core. So I'm just going to click Core Main here, and then we're going to go to viper.net, as it looks like HiveOS has already updated the pool list inside of HiveOS. So I'm just going to go with USA West here, Viper 5020, click on that like so. I don't even think it does anything because we're running the custom miner. And now I'm just going to go Kylacoin Video Test like so. So I'm going to name that. Now we're going to go Select Miner, Show All, type in CU for custom. Pick it and then set up our miner config. From there, we got to go in the TT miner beta. Here you can see HiveOS tar. I'm going to right click on this, copy link address, come back into HiveOS, and we're going to paste this right here. Here we can see if we put in flex, the algorithm should be here, right? Flex algorithm, wallet worker name. We're going to click that there. Now we need our pool URL. So we're going to come back into viper.net here, simply copy either one of these. You don't need the stratum plus TCP in HiveOS. Some miners you do, but for this one it doesn't. So you can choose either or, and then come back into your HiveOS here and paste it in there. Now before, we also had to add those extra parameters slash D for your device, and then we also had to add it in the dash A for the flex algorithm. It should be working right now, but we'll find out for sure. So I'm going to apply these changes, create that flight sheet, and let's see if it works. So there we go. So now I'm going to go in and pick a worker. I'm going to go to rig one right here, flight sheet. It should be the latest one you just made. As you can see, Kylacoin Video Test, and I'm going to hit the rocket ship and send that to the moon. I quickly SSH'd into my rig, and we can see everything is working just fine. So it is a lot easier to set up and mine Kylacoin on your CPUs now than it was in the previous day or two when it first forked, because TT Mined got a lot of updates. Things do seem really stable, and you don't have to add all those extra commands in anymore. So thank you for checking out this video. Hopefully it helped you out. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.